Hi and welcome back to my review of Giants Bobbleheads. Today let's take a look at the very special Bobby Thomson Bobblehead that was given away last Tuesday, July 19, 2011, against the Dodgers. This was a very classic pose. He's in his home run swing. Bobby Thomson depicted number 23 in his home New York Giants jersey. He is standing on top of what is actually a radio as his base. The radio call by Russ Hodges is probably one of the most famous home run calls that anyone's ever heard in history of baseball. The side of it says, "Shot heard around the world," with the date October 3rd, 1951. The little holes on the side for the speakers says the name Bobby Thomson on the base here. And the side is a little label that reads, "Bobby Thomson's game-winning home run at 3:58 p.m. October 3rd, 1951, gave the Giants a 5-4 victory against the Dodgers to win the pennant series 2-1. Yes, folks, the playoffs back then were not really playoffs. There were only, I think, 8 teams in the National League, so if you won the league, you went straight to the World Series. There were no playoffs, and so the Giants and Dodgers that year in 51 actually ended the season in a deadlock, and they had to go to a 3-game series, and the Giants won Game 1, the Dodgers won Game 2, and in Game 3, the ball on the ninth, one out, Ralph Branca threw that pitch high and inside, and, Bobby Thomson did what he did, and here's the home run call that I'm sure all of you are familiar with. It's a pretty cool call. I like this bobblehead. It's pretty cool looking. It's a very nice pose. It's one of the very rare ones I know of a non-announcer that actually got their own sound clip. Bobby Thomson, as you guys know, played for the New York Giants. He was actually a New York native, grew up in Staten Island, was drafted right out of high school in 1942 by the Giants. Unfortunately, there was a war going on, so he spent a couple years in the Air Force back in the day. And he didn't wind up actually playing for the Giants until 1946. He played up until through all the great years and all through 1953, and then was traded away to a couple teams before I think he ended his career with, I think he was in Japan last I was reading about. 1963 was the last year. In any case, he had a 15-year major league career. He was a 3-time All-Star, a career 270 hitter. He did hit 264 home runs for his career and at least 8 times hit at least 20, which is quite an accomplishment back in the day. He had over 1,000 RBIs, and he became a legend. And him and Ralph Branca went around signing a lot of autographs and had a great time on it. It's kind of an ironic thing where you did this one thing back in 1951, and still people are talking about it 50 years later. But they went around the country signing. You see him at autograph shows. Unfortunately, Bobby Thomson passed away last year, August 6, 2010, at the age of 86. But still, that's a lot of history, and I'm really appreciative the Giants are able to capture that history and celebrate the fact that before they came to San Francisco, there was a lot of baseball in the Giants tradition. I'm really happy that the Giants were willing to celebrate that and not pretend that baseball didn't exist until the franchise moved to California. In any case, that's my review of the Bobby Thomson bobblehead. Go out there and get it if you haven't. As always, thanks for watching. Go Giants. Bye. Hey there. So I thought I'd share a little bit more. As you guys know, every time I do a bobblehead review, I usually do about half hour of research, either online or through books or whatever resources I can find, old newspaper clippings, to find out what exactly it is we're celebrating, especially a character such as this Bobby Thomson, and arguably the most famous home run ever hit. It had an amazing backstory of this story. In 1951, the Giants were 13.5 games out in fourth place. Just looking up at the Dodgers were in first place, who were just killing the league at that time. And just out of a sudden, right after, the middle of the summer, the Giants went off and had a huge swing where they won 37 of the last 44 games to force a deadlock tie with the Dodgers at that time, the Brooklyn Dodgers. And it's kind of unique. Obviously in this day and age, everybody goes to the playoffs, but at that time there were only, I believe, 8 National League teams. And so when you won the league, you won the pennant, and you went immediately to World Series. There was no division series. There was no league championships. That was it. There were no playoffs. You went straight to the World Series, best of 7 series, and there you go. It wasn't as complicated as now, but back in 1951, it was pretty unique. It was very special. Up until that time, there had only been 2 other times where a deadlock tie for the league actually occurred, I think, in 46 and again at 48. So 1951 was only the third time a playoff for all the marbles actually occurred. A very interesting story. Bobby Thomson, he was drafted right out of high school in 1942. He didn't go to college. He was drafted. He grew up in Staten Island. He got to play for his hometown team. He played for the Giants right after he got out of the Army in 1946 until 1953. He was traded away to the Milwaukee Braves, where he played for a couple of years. The interesting story, I don't know if you guys know who Wally Pipp is, but Wally Pipp is a guy who had first base before Lou Gehrig did and then never got his job back. Well, same kind of thing happened with Bobby Thomson. Bobby Thomson joined the Milwaukee Braves, and unfortunately in spring training 1954, in that spring, he broke his ankle, and so the Braves had to call up somebody to take his spot. And fortunately, that guy who took his spot never gave it back, because it was this young 18-year-old African-American from Mobile, Alabama, named Henry Aaron. And so you can tell why, a couple years later, the Braves wound up trading Thomson back to the Giants for the 1957 season. Actually, Bobby Thomson was on the field that last game in 1957 at the Polo Grounds when they played their very final game before the Giants came west to become the San Francisco Giants. Unfortunately, Bobby Thomson was traded away to the Cubs that offseason and never made it to California for that 58 season. But he played for the Cubs all through 59, and he went on to play for the Red Sox and the Orioles in 1960 to complete a 15-year major league career, and eventually found himself playing in Japan for the Yomiuri Giants in 1963. Other tidbits for this game are pretty interesting. Bobby Thomson in 1951, that classic three-game series. You know, in game one, the Giants actually won that game, and ironically enough, they won. I believe the score was 2-1 or 3-1. Bobby Thomson actually had hit a home run off Ralph Branca, as he did several times during the regular season, and so seeing Branca come in for that third game was actually quite a shock and a lot of managerial nitpicking, you know, Monday morning quarterbacking. But why would you bring in the same guy to face the same guy only to have, like, the same thing happen, like, three or four times? You know, Branca throwing to Bobby Thomson inside fastball equals home run. And, you know, even today there's a lot of people questioning why he did that. Of course, that home run was hit with one out, and the very next batter, if Thomson had made an out, was this, you know, really young 20-year-old rookie center fielder for the Giants named Willie Mays. And so, who knows, maybe if he had made an out, or maybe that caught the fly ball, or if Game 3 had been played at Ebbets Field instead of Polo Grounds, that maybe would have been a fly ball out to the warning track, and we'd all be talking right now of a Willie Mays bobblehead shot heard around the world. It was a very interesting thing. The other thing that I noticed is that I was watching a video clip of Bobby Thomson do a loop around the track. I was also looking at old photographs of that field, where I noticed that all of the Dodger players were just completely shocked and dejected, and they're walking off the field except for one guy. If you look really closely in those video clips and in the photographs, there's only one guy, one Dodger, still in the field, the second baseman, Jackie Robinson. I was reading about it, and it was kind of interesting. Is he remembered something that happened years and years ago called Merkel's Boner, where someone hit like a double or something, and then he had to go from first base to touch second base, but because he actually walked off the field instead of touching second base, the game was called and had to redo it. And so the same thing happened. Jackie Robinson had the forethought and insight to actually watch Bobby Thomson circle the bases and make sure he touched every base, because if he didn't, say he was just hopping along and had missed a base, they could have thrown the ball back to Jackie Robinson, touch second base, Thomson's out, tie game, go to extra innings and sudden death. I mean, that's some serious, serious baseball smarts with probably no one else had thought of at the time. But, you know, it's not really a home run unless you actually step on every base, which is pretty cool insight in Jackie Robinson's mind there. Pretty smart guy. In any case, the home run call, Russ Hodges. Russ Hodges started his baseball career as a broadcaster in 1934 and became the number one Giants broadcaster in 1949 and for the next 22 seasons, even after they had moved and became the San Francisco Giants. Continued calling games all the way up into the summer and fall of 1970. Unfortunately, the very next spring after he retired, he died of a sudden heart attack, April 19, 1971, which is pretty unfortunate. I wish he had lived longer, so, you know, at least I maybe I've heard him. But again, you know, if you've ever talked to Lon Simmons, he's very dejected and sad that his longtime radio partner had died so suddenly. Of course, Lon Simmons and Russ Hodges are both now in the Hall of Fame with the Ford Frick Award, and they're both celebrated in their numbers. I guess their names are retired in the Giants Wall. Pretty cool story of everything that happened here. And the other, of course, the other interesting thing is they do call us the shot heard around the world, and because, you know, national radio broadcasts, even television broadcasts, were completely unheard of. This game was televised, but it wasn't recorded. This game was actually on the radio by six different radio stations, including the Armed Forces Radio Network. So they have these great stories about these soldiers who were fighting at that time, 1951, in Korea, who were listening to the Giants-Dodgers playoff series all the way halfway around the world, just, you know, on the edge of their seat. Dodger fans were really thinking they would finally won it and go to the World Series. Giants fans were really hoping that they would do something. And, of course, shot heard around the world because everyone just exploded in excitement when Bobby Thomson finally hit that home run. Pretty interesting thing. Of course, the other thing, the backstory, which is kind of unique, is the fact that none of those radio broadcasts up until about the 1960s were actually recorded. And so this sound clip of Russ Hodges going crazy talking about the Giants winning the pennant was actually recorded by a fan. It was, I think, a Giants fan living in Brooklyn. He had gone to work, and he asked his mom to record the game for him, and of course he did. He recorded the ninth inning on a tape recorder, and I guess in the off season he found Bobby Thomson and gave it to him and said, "This belongs to you. This is your home run." And without that fan and his mother participating in this whole epic, none of us would have that call for us to remember. So it's a very, very complex story. It's a wonderful, wonderful story. For those of you who are into baseball, you know, go beyond the sport and look into the history of it, the aspects of it, because, you know, this is the ultimate reality show. These are real human beings with real drama. You know, they live, they marry, they get kids. You know, they get divorced, they, you know, all these wonderful, crazy, crazy things happen, and it is the ultimate reality show. And so those of you who are interested in baseball, please pick up a history book, start reading. It's a wonderful, wonderful story. In any case, that's all I have to say about that. I'm sure I bored half of you guys out there, and hopefully piqued the interest of others. In any case, thanks for watching and indulging me. Thanks for watching. Go Giants. Bye.